And now on to our dinosaur of the day, Juravenator, which was a request from Ricardo via Patreon, so thanks. It was a Coelurosaurian theropod that lived in the late Jurassic in what is now Bavaria, Germany, and it was a small bipedal carnivore. Only one juvenile specimen has been found, and it's about 29.5 inches or 75 centimeters long.
Oh, little guy.
Yeah. Adults may have grown another 6 inches.
Oh, boy.
Still little.
Yeah.
The skull is proportionately large, and Juravenator had three-pronged claws and serrated teeth. It didn't have many maxillary teeth. The holotype has 8. It also had a short humerus and a long fenestra in the skull. That's that opening. It may have been nocturnal. That's based on these scleral rings. It also may have eaten insects or small lizards. Juravenator is a rare find, and it's one of the most complete theropods described in Europe. It's the second non-avian theropod found in the region of Solnhofen, and this shows the diversity of predatory dinosaurs in the late Jurassic in southern Germany. A patch of Juravenator fossilized skin from the tail has scales and traces of what might be simple feathers. Shuxing said that the scales on the tail may mean that there was more variety in feathers of early feathered dinosaurs than in modern birds. He also thought that the scales could be a primitive trait and that Juravenator and other primitive feathered dinosaurs may have had more scales than modern birds. A follow-up study of Juravenator supported Shuxing's thoughts and found faint impressions of possibly primitive feathers were on the top of the tail and the hips. In 2010, a study by Helmut Tischlinger looked at the fossils in ultraviolet light and found more filament-like structures, similar to primitive feathers found on other compsognathids, such as Cynosauropteryx. They also found more patches of soft tissue on the snout and lower leg, and collagen fibers in the tail vertebrae. Juravenator is not completely covered by fluffy feathers, like baby chicks, and that may mean that the feathers appeared on some parts of the dinosaur's bodies before others. The type species is Juravenator starkei, and it was described in 2006 by Ursula Golick and Louise Chiappi. The genus name comes from the Jura Mountains where it was found, and Venator means hunter, as we talked about earlier in Garrett's news item. The species name is in honor of the Stark family, who owns the quarry where it was found. From 1989 to 1998, the Jura Museum Eichstätt at Eichstätt had a collecting program for a nearby quarry. Two volunteers, the brothers Klaus Dieter and Hans Joachim Weiss, found a slab with vertebrate remains. The team found the head of a small theropod, but it was too difficult to extract the fossils, so they did a CT scan to see if it made sense to dig the rest up. They only saw the neck and part of the lower back and decided not to continue, though the find was reported in 1999. And then in 2001, there was some publicity around the fossil, and it got a nickname, Borstei, which is a name often given to bristle-haired dogs, because it was thought to have bristly proto-feathers. In 2003, the director of the museum, Martina Kolbert-Ebert, decided to finish preparing the fossil. Pino Vogel took 700 hours to prepare the fossil, which had almost the whole articulated skeleton, the end of the tail's missing, as well as soft tissue, so turned out to be a worthwhile excavation.
Yeah, so I guess that CT scan couldn't quite see everything that was in there.
Yeah, and then the publicity helped. So originally, Juravenator was thought to be part of Compsognathidae and a close relative of Compsognathus. In 2012, Akeem Reisdorf and Michael Wuke described the taphonomy of Juravenator, and they think that the specimen may have floated for a short time and then sunk to the bottom of the basin after it died. It was found in a strange rotated position. The way the pelvis is rotated with aspect to the torso was odd. So there was probably some predation or scavenging of the carcass, but it still doesn't explain the weird rotation.
Not too much scavenging because still have a pretty good...
Right, all but the end of the tail.
Yeah.
Enough to just move it around in weird ways.
Just fish nipping at the end of the tail. Enough to turn it, yeah.
For those of you who listen to our Dinosaur of the Day segment and you like it, please consider becoming a patron. We take new Dinosaur of the Day requests from our patrons and offer a bunch of other perks as well. So check out our page at patreon.com/inodino or click the link on the left.